Friend, nowadays everybody is talking about outcomes. Whatever work we are doing, whatever the activities we are doing, we always believe that we need to reach some outcome, some one or other sort of outcome. Whenever we are going outside the home with the list of tasks which we have to finish on that particular day, at the end of the day we always see like what kind of outcome we have achieved. Whether it could be a small work or it could be a bigger task. Forget about outside. Whenever you are having interaction with your family members, whenever you are talking with your children, whenever you are talking with your spouse, you always believe that at the end of that interaction, you want to have some sort of outcome out of that. Whenever you don't have any sort of outcome out of that deliberation or out of that interaction, you will always get irritated or you will always get frustrated. What does it mean? It means that when it comes to the individual activities we are doing, whether it is outside the home or within the home, we always making sure that at the end of that activity, at the end of that work, we will have something in our hand. But unfortunately, when it comes to the education, it's not only the colleges across the country. We are least bothered. Whatever curriculum we have as a teacher, I'm talking about. As a teacher, whenever we have a curriculum, we always believe that only delivery is going to be my responsibility. Outcome, I'm least bothered. Whether students, whatever I'm delivering, whether it's reaching to the student, whether the student are getting benefited, we are least bothered about that. And curriculum never talks about that as well. Forget about this now, I am not blaming teacher fraternity. Curriculum never talks about that. We don't have that sort of curriculum in which there would be a provision that this is what we are expecting at the end of this course. Like whenever you are teaching your student, students will be able to do this. They said this has not been mentioned in the curriculum. If you look at the overall education system outside the country, this outcome-based education, the concept of outcome-based education started implementing CCS together in most of the, foreign universities. And this is one of the, there are many reasons, this is one of the reasons why those universities are figuring out themselves in, QS World University ranking. If you look at the international ranking, QS World University ranking, you will hardly like first 100, if you see the first top 100 list QS ranking, you will not find single university from India. I am really surprised. The country, like very tiny country like South Korea, Taiwan, Singapore, Hong Kong, you will find one or two universities of these small countries in first 100. Although we are very high-profile, so-called high-profile institution in India, like IITs, NITs, ISERs, Indian Institute of, social science. Although we have these, high-profile institutions in India, but unfortunately, they are not able to figure out themselves in first 100 QS University, World University ranking. Now, question is why? Why they are not able to, appear themselves in first 100. If you look at the infrastructure, all those institutions which I'm just now referred, all those Indian Institute of Technologies, IITs, we have, more than 10 IITs, we have more than 5 ISERs, we have many NITs, right? We have many central universities, we have many, nowadays, many CSR laboratories got themselves, recognized as deemed universities. There are many high-profile institutions across the country wherein the government of India is spending crores of rupees. They are spending crores of rupees. They are getting substantial funding. In addition to this, if you talked about the intellectual manpower, they do have a wonderful intellectual manpower as well. If you look at the profile of individual faculty members who are working there, they are like every month that they will be visiting foreign universities. It means that they have their own credential as well. Then why? If we have a wonderful infrastructure with us, we have intellectual manpower with us, then why we are not able to figure out ourselves? There are many reasons, my friend. There are many reasons. one of the biggest reason is our mindset. Mindset is one of the biggest reasons. What I believe is, what we need to do is, first of all, we need to change our mindset. Unless we change our mindset, miracle will never happen. This is sort of miracle in Indian situation, right? But unfortunately, it is not happening. Moreover, as far as curriculum is concerned, as I mentioned earlier, there are many reasons why we are not able to figure out ourselves in first 100. One of the reasons, as I mentioned, is the mindset. The another very important reason is our curriculum. Although we have infrastructure, but unfortunately, we don't have proper curriculum. The topic which I'm going to talk today is outcome-based education and innovative teaching pedagogy. I will share my screen and then I will speak further. Can you see my screen, sir? Hello?
No, sir.
No. Okay.
Yes, now it is visible, sir.
Are you able to see PPT?
Yes.
Okay, good.
You just start slide, sir.
Are you able to see my first slide?
Yes. Now it is okay, sir. Mm.
Okay, thank you. So, my friend, today, as I mentioned, I will be speaking on outcome-based education and innovative teaching pedagogy. I request organizer, whenever I am not audible and whenever you are not able to see my screen, kindly keep me updated. Because okay. On my screen, I am not able to see anything except my screen. Okay? So, I won't be able to know whether I'm reaching you or not. So, kindly keep me notified if I'm not reaching you, right?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, friend, I was talking about outcome-based education and innovative teaching pedagogy. So, as I mentioned earlier, one of the reasons, there are many reasons, as I said, but one of the reasons why we are not able to figure out ourselves in top 100 universities is our curriculum. Our curriculum never talks about what we are going to achieve. Our curriculum never talks about what our student is going to gain at the end of the completion of the course. And at the same time, the innovative teaching pedagogy, we are since years together, we are using very conventional, method of teaching. And somehow, although those innovative teaching pedagogies are available and we're next to our door, but still, unfortunately, because of one or other reason, somehow we are not able to implement those. Many of the teachers, of course, there are good number of exemptions as well, right? There are many colleges and universities, they are using innovative teaching pedagogy, and then equal number of good number of teachers as well. But those numbers are very few in number. Now, as far as outcome-based education is concerned, in India, there are some universities where they are claiming that they have outcome-based education on paper. And they do have outcome-based education on paper. Most of the engineering colleges, they do have, because the National Board of Accreditation, right, NBA, has made them mandatory to have outcome-based education curriculum, that OBE-based curriculum. But unfortunately, again, there also, with very few exceptions, most of the engineering colleges, they have this OBE on paper only. Moreover, let me tell you, as far as Dr. Professor Ambedkar when we had last accreditation, NAC accreditation. Hello.
Yes, sir. We are listening.
Eco. We were going through the third of the NAC accreditation in 2018. We conducted many workshops, outcome-based education workshop, and then later on we started, you know, implementing OBE in reality since 2017-18, let me tell you, my friend. However, there are few departments, I'm not saying that all the department they started, because although our curriculum as on paper, if you see the curriculum, most of the university department, you will see our curriculum is outcome-based curriculum. But again, there are many, many hurdles in implementation. There are only few departments, they are still pursuing their curriculum through OBE mode, because there are many challenges as well. I'm going to tell you what are those challenges. So I just wanted to tell you, in India, there are few institutions they started doing, but somehow they could not, you know, institutionalize that practice of outcome-based education. This is where we are logging. So today, I will be focusing on all those aspects. So this is going to be outline my talk today. I will be telling you the importance of OBE to begin with. Then what is missing in conventional curriculum? What kind of, you know, what we are going to have in OBE and what we will be missing in conventional curriculum, that I will be highlighting. And then I will be highlighting on various, I mean, benefits of OBE and then various aspects of OBE. How COs and POs can be attend, how the attainment can be done. I'm going to tell you one case study as well of my own institution. And then as far as innovative teaching pedagogy is concerned, the flipped classroom is a kind of blended version, which we need to adopt. That I will be focusing maybe on 10-15 minutes on flipped classroom as well, and then I will be summarizing. As far as the importance of OBE is concerned, I will like to tell you in the NAAC criteria 2. I hope most of you, those who are listening this, most of you must be well familiar with NAAC accreditation and assessment and accreditation framework, right? As far as criteria 2 is concerned, you can see the criteria 2. This is going to be a very, very important criteria for affiliated colleges. You can see as far as the affiliated colleges are concerned, whether you are UG, PG, you are going to have a 350 marks out of 1000. And even if it is autonomous college, still you have 300 marks. And for the universities, it is 200 marks, because for universities, more wattage is given for research, innovation and extension activities. Now, as far as teaching, learning and evaluation is concerned, you can see there are 7 key indicators. Student enrollment and profile, catering to the student diversity, teaching, learning and process, teacher profile and quality, education process and reforms, student performance and learning outcome, and student satisfaction. If you look at all those 7 criteria, all those 7 key indicators, the 7 key indicators will revolve around outcome-based education. If you have outcome-based education, you will be able to have the better student enrollment. Because why we are not able to have a better student enrollment nowadays? Because most of the colleges, it's not only colleges, most of the universities are also struggling. Right, one of the reason, number one, they are not having adequate number of student enrolled, and whatever student they have enrolled, all of them are not coming in the class, right? They are not attending the classes. The reason is we don't have the proper curriculum. Somehow those curriculum, we are not able to attract our students in the classroom because of the outdated curriculum, right? So if you are having outcome based education, obviously you will be able to address the student enrollment. Catering to the student diversity. What kind of diversity we are talking about? It's not only the diversity in terms of caste, religion. This talks about everything. Diversity in terms of region, diversity in terms of religion and caste, diversity in terms of learning level. And I believe that if you start implementing outcome-based education, you will be able to address the student diversity. And how? I'm going to tell you in due course of time. Teaching learning process, yes, because teaching learning process is, we are going to be more accountable in outcome based education. We are going to be more accountable in conventional education. Our teaching is our all education system is teacher specific. It's not a student centric. Although we are saying that our education is student centric, but in reality it is not student centric. It is teacher centric only. Whatever teachers believes to speak, they are speaking. Whatever teacher believes to talk, they are talking and they are teaching. Nothing else. They are never talked about you know, like what is being transformed, how we are reaching to the student. Of course, again, I'm telling whatever the way and way criticizing, there are good number of teachers. There are good number of teachers. They are really genuine in nature. They are going beyond whatever the hurdles I'm talking about, whatever the issues I'm talking about. They are going beyond and they are trying their level best to reach the student. There are some teachers in every colleges and university. Teacher profile and quality, because if you are having outcome-based education, because nowadays, unfortunately, most of the institutions is not only colleges but university, the teaching recruitment is chaos. Like there has been tremendous chaos in teaching recruitment, because most of the time we don't recruit the teachers on the basis of their merit. We always follow linkages or money, right? We have a substantial impact of money and linkages and very less impact of teacher quality. Unfortunately, the reason is we are least bothered, na? We don't know, because nobody is going to ask you, nobody is going to evaluate your institution. Had there been the evaluation of that institution, that okay, fine, if you don't have this much passing percentage of student, if you don't have this kind of outcome, your institution is going to be stopped, your funding is going to be stopped. Let me tell you, my friend, if government start doing this, let me tell you, everything will start happening. It will start happening on the right path. But unfortunately, it is not. And that is why the teacher recruitment is being has been hampered like anything. And as a result of that, teacher profile and quality is very, very weak. And we are, most of the universities and colleges, they are struggling in this criteria as well. Evaluation process and reforms, because if you don't adopt outcome-based education, you are not going to have any reforms in your evaluation process. You will be following conventional method, right? Whatever the university is going to provide you, you will be following all as it is. You are not going to innovate. Right, innovation is going to be a part of, should be a part of your day-to-day activity. Unfortunately, it is not happening. Outcome-based education is going to compel you to do the innovation in evaluation process as well. Similarly, student purpose and learning outcome, we don't have in conventional education. We are not following the scientific method for evaluating the performance of students and their outcome, learning outcome. And since we don't have that scientific methods to evaluate the student performance and learning outcome of the courses, unfortunately we are least bothered and we are teaching the same similar kind of curriculum we have to be. However, if you follow outcome based education, you will be gaining substantially, and at the end of the day, student satisfaction. Because if you are having everything on board, students are going to be satisfied and you are going to get good marks. What does it mean? It means that if you look at all those 7 key indicators, these 7 key indicators revolves around outcome based education. And if you start following outcome based education in your institution, let me tell you, my friend, you can win the race. Now, question is, I'm sure most of the audience, they might be thinking that this is not our responsibility, this is the responsibility of university. Yes, I agree. Because aap ye sochte honge ki bhai ye to university ki zimmedari hai. University ka agar curriculum to hum nahi bana de, curriculum to university banata hai. Agar university agar outcome based education curriculum nahi deta, to what we can do? Let me tell you, my friend, I agree to some extent, I agree with you. This is the responsibility of university to provide all, like this kind of curriculum. But let me tell you, my friend, if university is not taking appropriate action, does it mean that you need to keep yourself idle? Absolutely not. University nahi kare iska matlab aapko idle nahi baithna hai. Let me tell you, my friend, you can adopt reverse engineering. Forget about because in this case, what we need to do, I'm going to tell you later that, but if university is not doing, you can do it. You can have the POs and COs in your curriculum, right? Forget, ab do curriculum is going to be provided by university, lekin aap usi curriculum mein aap POs dal sakte ho, COs dal sakte ho, and then at the end of every semester, you can see how you can make it compulsory for your teachers to do a CO attainment, you can ask your HODs to have the PO attainment, have a meeting at the end of each semester at college level, see what kind of hurdles you have and how system can be improved. This can be done even if at college level as well, although the university is not proactive. I'm going to be I will be going further. I have already mentioned this, but I will be quickly telling you what are the challenges of revised accreditation framework as far as criteria 2 is concerned, because these criteria revolves, as I mentioned earlier, revolves around outcome-based education. I thought, let me tell you more about this, right? I was talking about demand review. I was talking about diversity of student, like percent of student from other state and country. This has been removed now because NAIC has removed this key indicator. But still, if you in NIRF, it is going to be still important because NIRF is going to ask you what, how many students you have from other state, how many students you have from other country. Although NAIC has removed it, but again, NIRF may have been allowed. So, how many student diversity you have maintain karoge, curriculum aapka acha raha to you will be able to address student diversity, demand ratio matlab aapke paas student nahi hai courses ke liye, curriculum acha hai, student will, let me tell you my friend, there will be 360 degree revolution, I mean 180 degree revolution, let me tell you, and it is quite possible. You can have, if you are struggling to get student for your courses, if you revise your courses as per in OBA frame, I'm sure the student will start, he will get a good enrollment. And the student class mein nahi aate honge, student class mein aana shuru bhi kar denge. Identification of slow learners and advanced learners, you know, is another very important aspect in
Agro. Student will start, he will get a good enrollment. And the student class mein nahi aate honge, student class mein aana shuru bhi kar denge.
Again, there is echo, like organizer kindly take care of this echo if possible. So identification of slow learners and advanced learners, you can see if you are having outcome-based education,
इनामदार सर, हेलो इनामदार सर,
इनामदार सर, ट्राई टू मिनिमाइज इको प्लीज.
यस, आई विल स्टार्ट सर, आई विल काइंडली टेक केयर सर, बिकॉज कारण इको आल्यानंतर काय होतं माहिती आहे का, की तो टेम्पो राहणार नाही. ओके, आय होप यू विल बी टेकिंग केअर. Students and think you don't have any other option other than going for OBE. Use of ICT including LMS and e-resources. Because if you are more effectively, so this is going to be one of the challenge, and you will be able to address the challenge as well. Evaluation method, as I mentioned earlier, you will not have any reforms if you are following conventional method. Student complaint and grievances, although we are following student, because nowadays there are, you know, like there are two aspects. One, there are many student grievances, but students are not coming forward. They are not enough courageous to, you know, to come to us and record their grievances because of one or other reason. But if you are following OBE, it is going to be a student centric. You will be having less, very very less number of student complaints and grievances. It is the challenge can be easily addressed. And the revised accreditation framework that talks about attainment of COs, POs, and PSO in this OBE, it is compulsory. You have to do attainment, and then obviously you will be addressing the challenge as well. And obviously at the end, student satisfaction regarding teaching learning process, because OBE will make your student learning teaching learning process more student centric. Student will be very happy, and you will be able to satisfy all the expectations of your student. What does it mean? It means that whatever 350 marks you have for this criteria, you will be able to get, and most out of it, maybe around 350 out of 350. Outcome based. Now let us move further. What our students are, why our students are not able to happen. If I ask you, like for example, if you are teaching third year student and if you are having 50 students in your batch, if I ask you how many students are going to be employable at the age of after completion of this examination, it is very difficult for you to tell. because you don't have that kind of mechanism in the curriculum. Question is, but still we are least bothered, right? We are least bothered. हमारे student employable नहीं है, उनको job लगता नहीं है, लेकिन we are least bothered. क्योंकि हम उसके बारे में कभी सोचते ही नहीं. The question is, my our students are not employable. The reason is, we need to ask ourselves, are we importing calling skills through existing curriculum? हमारा जो existing curriculum है, conventional curriculum है, ये जो skill की मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, are we really importing those skills? What are those skills like communication? Are we importing? We are teaching Marathi, Hindi, English, but we never talked about competitive languages. Honesty and integrity. We don't include this in our curriculum. Teamwork skill. We don't include in our curriculum. Interpersonal skill. Strong work ethics. Motivation and initiatives. Flexibility and adaptability. Whatever situation you have, the student need to be very flexible. They need to be adaptable. We don't never talks about that. Analytical skills of friendly creativity, sense of humor, right? Integer. All this, if you look at this list, you know, this is what it is needed. If you really want your student to be employable, you need to have these skills. You should impart those skills to your student. But unfortunately, we never have the gap, right? So at the gap, we need to see how those gap can be. Does this existing curricula speak about learning outcome? Absolutely no. Now I'm going to have some philosophical questions. What is more important in our life, right? Destination or journey? If you are asking yourself, like, whether my journey important or destination is important, playing well in the game or winning the game. आपको पता होगा कि एक बार महेंद्र सिंह धोनी, उससे पहले महेंद्र सिंह धोनी ने बहुत सारे मैच जीता है, but still he lost one of the match in enjoying or just finishing the playbook. जब आप कोई किताब पढ़ते हो तो किताब फिनिश करना इंपॉर्टेंट है या जो पढ़ रहे हो उसको right? Then doing official work, like whenever it comes to ourselves, doing our official work throughout the month is important or salary is important, right? These are some critical philosophical question. If you look at this question, if you ask, if somebody asking me, I will say both is important. Like my, I would like to have my journey, destination. I would like, if I'm Bombay, so my destination is important, but the way in which I will be traveling, that journey is also going to be very important for me. But journey is also important. And outcome-based education talks about this only. It's not only the outcome, but how the journey, it's not only the destination, but how journey is going to be there, it talks about that journey as well. So what are the focuses and benefits of outcome-based education? OB address the following key questions. What are those? Again, these key questions are related to the NAAC assessment to have or able to do. This outcome-based education is going to tell us what our students will be able to do at the completion of the course. This means design. Right, this NAAC talks about designing curriculum, and if you design curriculum systematically, you will be able to make sure that your student will be able to do this and this, right? Then how can we best help student to achieve it? मतलब आप आपके student को कैसे help करोगे? वो जो target आपने set किया, वो achieve करने के लिए आप student को कैसे help करेंगे? This is what the planning and implementation is all about, right? Then how will we know whether the student have achieved it? मतलब student ने जो हमने सोचा, वो student ने achieve किया या नहीं? ये कैसे पता चलेगा? Assessment of learning outcome. NAAC talks about assessment of learning outcome. And the last is how do we close the loop for further improvement. Matlab, whenever you are talking about improvement, we need to have the closed loop. Right? It should not be open-ended. Closed loop means, if you start today, if you start designing curriculum, again, what you need to do? Design the curriculum, implement it, see the result, you know, assess the curriculum, assess the outcome, identify the gaps, have some suggestions, and make those you know, changes in our curriculum, and then again repeat the process. This is what we call as continuous quality improvement, and OBE talks about continuous quality improvement. About input output based education, it's like, it's not only out, because earlier we were talking about only our inputs were measurable, right? Just like financial resources hamare kya wo measurable hua karte the, ki how much money I'm investing, lab equipment, how much money I'm investing, right? It was measurable, right? Equipment kitne hain, faculty, how many faculties, the number of quality student, like whatever student you have, how many are good, how many are, but output was not used to be measurable. Abhi kya hai, your output is, outcome of education will tell us about output is also being measurable. What is that? Number of students graduating. How many students? Because earlier we were list bothered. Hamare paas student aaye, 100 aaye, kitne pass hue, we are list bothered. But now they are going to, NAC is going to ask you, what is your passing percentage? It's not only success rate of the student, that is also very important. Like dropouts, you know, if you are having, let us say, 100 students in the first year in 2017-18, so every 3-year course, how many of them are going to complete the degree within the stipulated time? If there are 100 students, 3 saal mein 17 ko agar enroll hue, the 20th ko usne bahar nikalna chahiye. So if 100 students were enrolled in 17, how many of them got the degree in 2020? So success rate is also going to be important. So measurable outcome is also going to be important. Picture of what is important for the student. Or it's not only curriculum, because outcome-based education very an assessment. It's combination of three, and that is why outcome-based education is always going to be very, very important. So I was talking about continuous quality improvement. This is what the continuous quality improvement is. Say what you do, मतलब आप जो करने वाले हैं वही बोलिए, and जो आपने बोला है वही करिए. Do what you say. And prove it. हमारे पास क्या हो रहा है अभी, हम तो बड़े political leader जैसे हो गए, truly speaking we are academician, हमने तो political leader जैसे करना नहीं चाहिए, हम तो कहते एक है और करते कुछ और है, जो जो कहते वो करते ही नहीं, जो करते वो कहते ही नहीं. Outcome based education will compel you to say whatever you are doing and compel you to do and once you prove it in your process. I said kabhi bhi nahi hoga ki aap process shuru karenge aaj and you will be reaching to your home. Whatever, whenever you are going to start, you are bound to have one or other issues, right? Those issues need to be improved in due course of time, and this is mandatory, and this is what the closed loop is going to be in outcome-based education. Outcome-based education talks about these four parameters. What is this? Is OBE, outcome-based education, what the student should able to do. So OBE talks about curriculum. OBCE curriculum talks about how to make the student achieve your outcome. Whatever you have projected in OBE, curriculum is going to tell you how you will and then how to measure it, whatever you are going to achieve, whatever you have projected, how do you call as outcome based learning teaching, and then outcome based assessment. So OBE, OBC, OBLT and OBA are going to be integral parameters of outcome based education. So I would like to spend some time here. OBE framework, what the OBE framework is all about. Fortunately, like NAC has given us wonderful opportunity. There too, genuine in the sense, मतलब बहुत सारे लोग honest नहीं हैं. Feedback नाम की feedback लेते, NAC पूछता है ठीक है भाई, अपने stakeholders सभी employer, alumni, parents, teacher, student सभी से आपने लिया, हम कहते yes. आपने analysis किया, हम कहते yes. आपने action taken किया, हम कहते yes. उसके बावजूद भी हमारे student क्यों, हमारे student का outcome अच्छा नहीं है? अगर ये अगर honest अगर है हम फीडबैक लेने में, अगर सही मायनों में अगर ऑनेस्ट है, सो व्हाई वी आर नॉट एबल टू प्रोग्रेस, इट मींस वी आर नॉट ऑनेस्ट, राइट? सो आउटकम बेस्ड एजुकेशन फ्रेमवर्क में सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट है इंडस्ट्री एंड प्रोफेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इनपुट एंड फीडबैक. तो जो फीडबैक हमें चाहिए, यू कलेक्ट इज नॉट ओनली इंडस्ट्री, ऑल फाइव स्टेक होल्डर्स, उसमें स्टूडेंट रहेगा, एलुमनाई, पेरेंट्स, एम्प्लॉयर्स एंड टीचर्स, ऑल those five stakeholders, you collect feedback genuinely, right? Genuine feedback collection is not happening in most of the institutions across the country. And then, based on that, you need to decide your... आप कहेंगे कि क्या हम हर साल रीजन मिशन चेंज करेंगे? No. आपको हो सकता है, यूजुअली विजन तो आपका एक 10-20 साल चलेगा, बिकॉज विजन इज गोइंग टू ऑलवेज प्रोजेक्ट, यूर विजन स्टेटमेंट इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी सन्स आउट सम सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ योर इंस्टीट्यूशन, व्हाट यू वांट टू योर, वेयर यू वांट टू लुक योर इंस्टीट्यूशन आफ्टर 10 इयर्स और आफ्टर 20 इयर्स, 10 साल बाद आप आपके इंस्टीट्यूट को कहां देखना चाहते हो, दिस इज व्हाट विजन इज. लेकिन इसलिए वो हर साल जो इनपुट होगा, फीडबैक होगा, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ फीडबैक यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू चेंज योर विजन. लेकिन जब नेचुरल कलैमिटी आएगी, जैसे कि अभी कोरोना वायरस आया है, अकॉर्डिंगली वी मे नीड टू चेंज योर विजन एज वेल, राइट? बिकॉज अभी अगर विजन में चेंज नहीं करेंगे हम, तो फिर तो हम कहीं के नहीं रह जाएंगे, राइट? सो व्हेनेवर यू हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ नेचुरल कलैमिटीज, यू नीड टू चेंज योर विजन एज वेल, राइट? बट एज पर एज मिशन इज कंसर्न, यू कैन कीप ऑन चेंजिंग योर मिशन, बिकॉज मिशन इज अ सॉर्ट ऑफ यू नो स्ट्रेटेजिकल steps to achieve your vision, right? Those can be changes based on your input. So whenever you are receiving input, you change your vision, mission, right? And then this input, you have to define your program educational objective. I'm going to tell you what the program educational objective is going to be. I'm going to tell you in due course and time. So program educational objectives, POs, and then POs, program outcome, PSOs, program specific outcome. So three different terminology. PEO, program educational objective, you have to define based on the feedback. Then program is going to be program specific outcome. I'm going to tell you all those things in detail. And then this is what about student outcome, because this PEO, POs and PSO will tell you what could be a student outcome after completion of the degree or a PG program. And learning, course learning outcome, because you are going to have various courses. Let us say you have BSc program, right? BSc physics, okay, PCM group, or MSc physics, for example, right? In one program. And then what would be like classical mechanics, quantum mechanics, computer applications, right? Digital electronics. What would be course outcome of each every course, so that you will going to define right in the beginning. So outcome as education kaise define karte, sabse pehle aapko PEO likhna padega, sabse pehle uske baad mein PO likhna padega, uske baad mein PSO likhna padega, then let us say you want to frame the syllabus of electronics, aapko uske course ke outcome likhne padenge pehle, and then you will be drafting the curriculum. So based on PEO, PO, PSOs and COs, the curriculum or syllabus of that particular course, then he will be mentioning what kind of teaching methods he will be applying, what would be learning activities he will be having, and what would be assessment tools. And then you will be planning it, you will be applying it, you will be delivering it, and then once it is done, then this is what we call as course planning and delivery. Then then next part is going to be assessment. So once you have delivered, आपने सिलेबस डिजाइन किया, टीच हो गया, एक बच्चों ने एग्जाम दिया, then you are going to do the assessment. In assessment, first of all you are going to do course assessment first. Attainment, how you are going to see like what kind of attainment you have. I'm going to tell you how to achieve, how to calculate the course attainment as well. And then once you assess your course, then you can assess your program. So course can be assessed by individual teacher, the person who is teaching, and head of the department is going to assess the program as a whole. And then principal or the chancellor of the university or dean of the respective faculty is going to assess the entire program in the university. And then they are going to, whenever you are assessing them, they are going to identify some gaps, right? Once the identification of gaps is done, you have to have some improvements. You have to have some measures for that, to how whatever gaps you have identified, jo bhi gap aapne identify kiya, then आपको कुछ टारगेट आपको रखने पड़ेंगे कि ओके इफ यू डू दिस यू विल बी एबल टू मिनिमाइज द गैप, यू विल बी एबल टू ब्रिज द गैप. सो दैट मेजर्स यू हैव टू सजेस्ट हियर एंड देन अगेन यू हैव टू स्टार्ट. सो दिस इज हाउ द क्लोज लूप इज गोइंग टू बी इन आउटकम बेस्ड एजुकेशन. एंड डू डोंट यू थिंक दैट दिस इज अ वंडरफुल मैकेनिज्म? व्हाट आर द की कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स इन आउटकम बेस्ड एजुकेशन? जैसे मैंने बताया, विजन मिशन, उसके बाद रहेगा प्रोग्राम एजुकेशनल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, देन प्रोग्राम आउटकम, प्रोग्राम स्पेसिफिक आउटकम, एंड जितने भी कोर्सेस रहेंगे उसके कोर्स आउटकम. सो दिस पीएसओ, पीओस एंड कोर्स आउटकम, दीज आर गोइंग टू बी, वी कॉल इट एज ए स्टूडेंट ग्रेजुएट एट्रीब्यूट्स, वी कॉल इट एज ए ग्रेजुएट एट्रीब्यूट्स. नाउ व्हेनेवर यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट विजन, योर विजन शुड बी वेरी वेरी क्लियर. लेट मी गिव यू सम idea about any institution. A strong vision has to frame the people's mind. Organization will different in future. It also helps people to assumption may no longer be valid. Iska matlab ye hai, aapka jo vision hai, it is going to be important for you to tell the people that I would like to take my institution to that destination. है मेरी इंस्टीट्यूशन को मैं यहां देखना चाहता हूं. ये दिस इज गोइंग टू बी वंडरफुल अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर लीडर ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशन टू प्रोजेक्ट योर इंस्टीट्यूशन, लाइक वेयर यू वांट टू सी योर. General Electric. विजन क्या करेगा? विजन कैन टेक यू फ्रॉम गुड टू मेडियोकर टू मेडियोकर टू एक्सेलेंस, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली इफ यू थिंक दैट यू आर बेस्ट राइट इन द बिगिनिंग, देन ऑब्वियसली यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू इम्प्रूव एनी मोर. देयरफॉर व्हेनेवर यू आर most importantly, I'm going to skip those two slides. Okay. I'm going to tell you the difference between course, degree, and program. Because there are a lot of confusion about the course, program, and degree. Friend, the course. I will start from degree. I will start from BCom, MCom. Let us say MSc. So you have got MSc, MA in your college. You have got MSc and MA in different degree program. Whenever it talks to physics, whatever course is electronics, these are going to be the courses. This is the difference between course, degree and program. Whenever we are designing PEOs, POs, PSOs, COs, we need to follow Bloom taxonomy. What is Bloom taxonomy? Ye aisa kuch nahi hai. Kya batata hai Bloom taxonomy? It is a kind of pyramid. You can see the bottom of pyramid is remembering capacity. It means whenever you are designing curriculum, you need to make sure that students are going to have the skills or the skills of remembering. Students are going to earn the skills of understanding. Students are going to earn the skills of applying. It's not only remembering and understanding, but applying. Then analyzing too. A student must be able to analyze. Student must be able to evaluate. A student must be able to provide his pyramid is creativity and bottom pyramid is remember. You see. So conventional education only remembering and it talks about application, analysis, evaluation and creativity. So whenever designing curriculum, you need to make earn all those skills. It's not only designing, whenever you are teaching, because I said there are three different of the skills. Whenever you are delivering, you need to make sure that your delivery is going to be important for student, helping student to gain all those skills. And at the same time, assessment, whenever you are evaluating student, whenever you are taking question paper, there will be some questions which will test the student remembering capability, understanding capabilities, applying capabilities, analyzing capabilities, evaluation capability and creative capability. पे कहीं जोर हो ही नहीं है. सो इफ यू फॉलो आउटकम बेस्ड एजुकेशन, इट्स नॉट ओनली करिकुलम, इट्स नॉट ओनली डिलीवरी, यू हैव आउटकम बेस्ड एजुकेशन इवॉल्व प्रोग्राम. नाउ आई विल बी to evolve program educational objective. This is the concept. First of all, you need to follow the educational institution need to follow the consultation. To whom? Industries, alumni, students, management, faculty as well. Because in the college, teachers are list. I mean, teacher ko importance nahi diya jata. No, teacher is one of the important stakeholder. Ab teacher ka bhi feedback lena chahiye. Parents. And then whatever data you have, right? So this is the consultation process. So unless you have this, this is what the feedback is talking about. I talked about the feedback. This is what the feedback. Then summary of views during that you got, something will be may not be doable for your institution, like whatever feedback you have, like everything is whatever it has been suggested by all stakeholders, everything is not going to be implementable, right? So you need to see like what is doable and what is not doable, right? And then accordingly you need to start writing program educational objectives and POs and COs and PSOs. And let us move further now. What is PEO? Right? We talked a lot about ODE. Now, what is PEO? Program Educational Objectives. Program graduates are expected to attend within few years of graduation. Matlab, these are going to be broad statements, right? Program educational objectives are going to be broad statement. What they expect, like you are going to write your expectation, on the MSc, because POs are aimed, so you need to see POs and POs are going to be same for one program, like MSc. If you are having MSc, like three different, so your POs and POs for all MSc program is going to be same, and PSO is going to be, this is going to be different, MSc is going to be different. POs. POs are program outcomes which are narrow statement. POs are broader statement. Program outcomes are narrow statement that describe the students are expected to know. But here program outcome will be very specific. Very specifically, you need to mention what student will be able to do. Guidelines for POs, program outcome basically describes knowledge, skills and behavior of the student as they progress through the program. PO should not be too broad. PO could be broad. Program educational objective could be broad. But PO, program outcome, should be narrow statement. They must align with the, they must reflect the graduate, align and reflect the graduate attributes. Then PSO, as I mentioned, if you are having MSc program, let us MSc chemistry, MSc botany, and MSc four program. So all those four program, you can have same PSOs are going to be different. MSc chemistry, narrow statement that describes knowledge and ability specific domain. That would be a little bit broader in view, but this would be a very specific domain we'll be able to do. And the next will be a CRD-defined PSOs, and now there are different codes going to design the curriculum. The course outcome should be, course should not be teacher focused. Very important. There should be alignment of course, outcome with program and institutional level. Like whatever POs you have, whatever abilities of the student, this is very, very important. Focus on the learning aspect of the student. These are should be limited in number because they're specific enough POs that should be measurable. मतलब आपको मेजर करते आना चाहिए, ओपन एंडेड नहीं होने चाहिए. ओपन एंडेड का मतलब क्या है कि जो मेजर नहीं हो गए, राइट? एंड यू शुड फॉलो ब्लूम टैक्सोनॉमी. ब्लूम टैक्सोनॉमी में जैसे भी है इवैल्यूएटिंग कैपेसिटी है, असेस इवैल्यूएटिंग एंड देन पैरामीटर्स नीड टू बी टेकन केयर ऑफ. एंड दिस इज हाउ यू नो पीओज पीओ विजन एंड देन यू आर गोइंग टू हैव पीओज एंड देन दिस इज हाउ द लाइक ऑल सीओज पीओज एंड ग्रेजुएट आउट should coincide here, right? So this is some kind of diagrammatic representation of POs. Case study of my own exam, my own course. We are running Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University. We are running. I'm going to tell you this one exam. This is one program. Many of you must be knowing that after 6 months, students are going to have first exit, second exit, after 1 year, third exit, after 2 years, and after third exit. It doesn't. It's not like normal exit. जब हम exit की बात करते हैं, इसका मतलब जब मान लो अगर बच्चा यहाँ से छोड़कर जाता है, तो he must be able to at this level, right? मतलब उस क्या हम because at the first exit they are going to have certificate. So certificate lene ke baad kuch to employment milna chahiye. So he must be able to skill so that he will be employable. After 2 years he must be able this advanced diploma, he must be able to earn that kind of skill so that he will be employed at the end. It's like a degree program. Unfortunately BO program kabhi kabada ho gaya hamare India mein, kyunki under blaming only institution. यहाँ पर सबको सभी का मैं सभी को ब्लेम करूंगा क्योंकि यूजीसी एमएचआरडी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया जिन्होंने प्रोग्राम जिस पर्पस के लिए अलॉट किए थे दे आर लिस्ट बॉदर. अलॉटमेंट के बाद में कोच क्या कर रहा है देख ही नहीं रहे, उनके पास कोई सिस्टमेटिक मॉनिटरिंग देख नहीं रहे. सभी को एक दे आर ट्रीटिंग एवरीबडी एट वन. दिस इज मोस्ट अनफॉर्चुनेट. फॉरगेट अबाउट यूजीसी, फॉरगेट अबाउट एमएचआरडी. जिन लोगों को पैसा मिला है, देर आर वेरी फ्यू across the country who are really genuine and very honest making use of the money. Most of them are not utilizing money properly. As a result of that, ye sab multiples ka koi matlab hi nahi ho. Okay, I'm going to tell you what are program educational objective of my BHU program. You can see these are broader statement. First, POs provide socially responsible environment friendly solution to industrial automation related broad statement. Adopt state of the art industrial automation based broad based technologies to work in multidisciplinary work. Solve broad based problem individually and as a team member. So these are very broad statement. And then I'm going to tell you program outcome. These are going to be narrow statement, right? What are those? You can see the first POs, engineer and society. I would like my student to assess societal, health, safety, legal and cultural issues and the consequent responsibility relevant to practice in the field of industrial automation. Then environment and sustainability, apply industrial automation solution for sustainable development practices in societal and environmental record. Third is design for modern tools and so on and so forth. So I can see like I started with very broad statement, program education objectives, and then narrow statement. Still, you know, this is still that is not that much narrow, and this is very specific. Some specific outcome are very specific. And this is the course I was talking about. This is a 6-semester course. You can see this is like this is wonderful program, wonderful blends rather, because they talks about the linguistic proficiency. I told this is very very outcome based education, right? Because in conventional program we teaches like languages, right? But we never talks about linguistic proficiency. In BMO we are talking about linguistic proficiency, English and Marathi, basic computing, US UPS repairing. And then this is industrial automation skill. Linguistic proficiency higher version. Computer fundamental, environmental management. This is general education. As far as skills are concerned, this is related to industrial automation. Third semester, again linguistic. This is higher version. Like we teach, it is not like we are teaching how to speak. We are teaching how to write. We are teaching how to present, right? Then a business software model. We are teaching them how the what are the different software models, statistical tools, right? Then industrial ethics and safety management, fundamental of business and accounting. We are in industrial automation. You see, we are teaching them business model again. Then professional development, stress management, operational management, business communication, production teaching about general education. It's not like skills. Skill will be related to industrial automation. Foreign language, we are also teaching one of the foreign language. Entrepreneurship development, pumps, production management, how like. So this course is specifically designed to either student can be, will be able to have the job in the industries, or they can start their own enterprise, right? So that is why we are teaching this kind of skills to the student. Okay, now this is all about like POs, PESOs and POs. Now let us talk about CO, course outcome. Now this is one example, like one course, VOC 411, PLC based automation. Now what is this? Like you can see I am having five different COs. On completion of the course, student will able to, it means we able to understand, discuss, formulate, design. This is what we have to write. So first of all, we have to write PO, PO, PSO, course outcome, and then you have to design the curriculum. So with respect to your code, because क्या होगा ना, इससे आप पहले project करेंगे कि आपका student कहाँ पर आप job, आप कहाँ आपके student को देखना चाहते हैं. Like for example, after completion of this course, you would like your student to go to the industry, banking sector or competitive examination. आप जहाँ पर आपके student को देखना चाहोगे, that kind of curriculum be there in your structure, in your course, right? And therefore, first of all, this is kind of projection, like where you want your student to up